first and foremost, importante po yung may training yung mga teachers nila. Kasi kaya sila hindi natututo din dahil hindi, baka hindi rin effective yung instruction na namibigay sa kanila. So I think that one solution for this is if we equip our teachers with the proper knowledge and the proper experiences with dealing with children with special needs, then perhaps they'll be able to answer to these needs better for the sake of the children also.
As much as it is a perception problem, the problems that the deaf community faces is structural. For instance, we don't have, for example, disabled people, we don't have as many ramps as we should have. For deaf people, we don't have as many awareness campaigns on how to properly handle them.
Feeling ko definitely kailangan ng increase in government programs. Katulad nung sa Bohol, where they have an actual deaf community na sila yung nag-run by themselves. Meron kasing nag-rise ngayon na mentality na deafness is not really a disability more than it is an identity, and feeling ko it's about time that governments embrace that idea so that it's easier for people to grant them rights na equal to everyone else who can actually hear.
Welcome back. Our question, how can we help push the rights of the deaf? Maybe we will go and ask each one of you. We barely have a few minutes left. Well, we will start with you. You're pushing for the rights of the deaf with this bill that you say is going to be easily supported by your colleagues.
Actually, Tina, we are pushing for two bills for the deaf community. Mm. First, ito na nga sign language Inset. Mm. But another bill is House Bill 4631, where we are mandating the use of sign language interpreters in the judicial, quasi-judicial proceedings, public hearings, no? So yung sa mga courts natin, sa mga regulatory commissions, whenever there are deaf people involved in the proceedings, we are requiring, or we want to require that agency to provide deaf interpreters. Mm-hmm. And this is also a very urgent request from the deaf community, kasi maraming mga kaso sa korte natatalo kasi walang interpreter, hindi maintindihan ng deaf ano na yung status ng kaso. Especially in judicial and quasi-judicial proceedings, it's a very technical field. And, you know, not everyone probably can translate all these legal principles.
But you can actually, the judge can actually order whoever wants to.
There are provisions, no, but there's one problem there, yung funding, for example, not enough funds are really put into it. Tsaka depende yan sa kung gaano ka aware yung judge or yung court tuon sa pangangailangan. So we want to make it standard, no?
Diba, parang you have to have a subject matter expert or resource person.
Right, right. So kung may binge, whether it is a witness or a respondent or a plaintiff, dapat may ano yon, may sign language interpreter.
Yeah, that's good. So these two bills, Lisa, how do you still want to push the rights of the deaf in the field that you're in?
4631 is very critical because the motivation for sign language interpreting are cases which are gender-based violence. Mm-hmm. Yeah. In the past 5 years, the PDRC has documented over 327 cases which involve deaf people, and about two-thirds of those involve cases where the deaf person is the complainant, and half of those are rape cases. Mm-hmm. And typically, a deaf rape victim is unschooled, and therefore does not even sign in the more what we call standard variety of the community. Mm. So they need a deaf person who does what Macky mentioned earlier, a deaf relay interpreter. Mm. So it becomes a very complex process in the court. Well, even for hearing people, it's a complicated process, but communication is difficult. So existing Supreme Court policy is very, very skeletal. It just talks about that if a deaf person needs to be understood, that's when you put a sign language interpreter. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't even say that if a deaf person would like to understand what's going on around him or her, then that would also
require... If you're directly, either you're the, or you're the defendant or you're the...
Yes, a witness or you're accused of a certain crime.
Okay. Mm. How about in the field of the academic community?
Well,
where do you want to push it?
In the academic, it's for us in Benilde, it's a lot of educating on our part. But let me speak also as a member of the Philippine National Association of Sign Language Interpreters. I think you